So yeah, my name is Angelique Geiger. I'm a fourth year student. I'm doing my teacher's training in Dresden. And I'm studying English and history at first of all, I would like to thank you for letting me be here. This is actually my first conference ever, so it's quite a big start. And bear with me if I seem a bit nervous. I'm really quite nervous. So, why do I talk about relationship? This is actually, the title is kind of misleading. I'm not really going to talk too much about the relationship, sort of more about the relationship and their daughter Helena, which I think doesn't get enough credit for it. So, my research was kind of based on the attachment theory, and basically this just this idea that our parents are the first gender roles or the first gender norms that we get introduced to, and that our parents are usually our role models in this way. So I'm going to look at this little cutie and talk about how her parents affect her in a way and how she might turn out to be, and the gender roles that Bill and Alice present her with and how that affect her and how she might change. First of all, I'll talk about Bill's and Alice's impact on her, and I'll kind of take a bit of an, I'd say, feminist approach. These people were hoping for that to come. And a bit of a gender studies approach, I'd say. So, as we introduce to Alice, this is the first thing we see of her. We see her undressing in front of a mirror, as we already talked about. So I'll be repeating a few things that we already heard. And but she's also framed by these two pillars, as you can see. So I think that is kind of reminiscent of being like a Greek statue and just manifests her beauty, actually, because she looks like a vicious beauty, obviously. And it just shows her to be this very, the epitome of beauty in this way, especially because of these pillars. And in the background, you can hear Shostakovich's Waltz number 2, which I kind of saw as a, well, the opposite to that which we should see, because it's a waltz. You usually don't waltz on your own, you usually do that in pairs. But she is on her own in the first scene, so I think that kind of gives her this sense of autonomy. As we already talked about, we often see Alice standing in front of mirrors, which does not only, so the camera does not only induce her to her appearance, but I think the way, the fact that she's often in front of mirrors, looking at herself, mostly being naked, I think gives her this sense of confidence in her beauty, but also kind of confidence in her sexuality. And it also just elevates her beauty a bit more, because she's so self-aware of it, and it just makes her seem even more beautiful than she already is. Talking about the pot scene, or the weed scene, with the naval officer, that also kind of manifests, again, Alice as this sexually very confident woman, and maybe a feminist woman in terms of like fourth wave feminism. But the Ziegler's party kind of works against this whole thing. So at the party, we find out that Alice used to work at an art gallery, and she is allegedly looking for a job, but we never really see her looking. Which is kind of like the big thing that started this whole paper, because I was feeling like if she was actually looking for a job, we should see her looking for a job, because we see that very mundane life. And that kind of sparked for me this idea that she is, because she only curates her beauty, kind of more like this trophy wife, not a housewife, but not like a, nothing more than that. So we see Bill as the breadwinner, and Alice as the housewife and trophy wife. And just to kind of summarize her quickly, she's this sexually confident woman. She is sort of sexually liberated. She's beautiful, and she knows it, and she creates her beauty quite well. But she's financially dependent on her husband, and so that kind of makes her very traditional and a bit conservative. But also also because of her sexual independence, feminist in terms of fourth wave feminism, but not feminist in terms of first and the second and third wave feminism. So, but her confidence, as I talked about, is kind of challenged mostly by her husband. As you can see in this scene, Bill doesn't really pay any attention to the beauty that she's working so hard on. And we also know that this honeymoon phase is kind of over, and they are long past that, but also suggests this strong sense of comfortability in their relationship. So it's a very settled marriage. They're both happy, probably, hopefully. But there's no real spark left. And as we talked about yesterday already, the first verbal communication in the film, I believe, is Bill asking Alice where his wallet is, and it's on the bedside table. So that kind of brings in this connection between sex and money, and Alice being a potential prostitute, or being seen as a potential prostitute. This connection between money and sex is further elaborated when he meets Domino. And he's quite uncomfortable talking about money with her, because he's like, I suppose we should talk about money, and then he does that weird giggle, and she's like, yeah, we should. And so that just kind of further shows that Bill knows that sex and money, they do go well together in his world. But he's much more comfortable in his effective and continuous efforts to kind of facilitate the patriarchal structures that he's kind of caught up in. We already saw that at the Zeeklas party when Mandy, I believe, passed out, and he's kind of helping him cover the whole thing up so nobody knows about it. So he's very much part of the system, and he's very much helping to keep it up. And here we can see him silencing Domino, so he can talk to his wife, which then also shows this clear division between domestic love and pleasure. Because he, at this point, has no understanding of female sexuality. And also, nice side note, I think, because that always reminded me a bit of Helena, because the way that she poses on the bed with the stuffed tiger on behind her, I think makes it seem quite childish and not very the way I would imagine a prostitute to lie on a bed with the stuffed tiger behind her, because that's a bit weird. And also, I think a nice comparison between the two is that I think mostly all of the women in the film have red hair, and Helena is red hair and she's a redhead, so I think it's just a nice comparison between them. So to summarize Bill, he's sexist, and he's a supporter of the patriarchal structures, and he's quite careless about money, and he's super insecure about his masculinity, and he uses money to establish power. So we have this nice triangle between money, sex, and power. And all these things, of course, passively affect Helena and her development, because he's her father. She kind of always gets a glimpse of all these things, and that affects her development. So let's talk about these two. Because so far, Bill kind of seems like the bad guy in the relationship, and especially in Helena's development, and as a bad influence. But why would I talk specifically about Alice and Helena? As I already said, Alice is the housewife, so she's most likely to spend most time with her daughter, and she's probably the biggest impact on her. In many scenes, we see Helena and Alice working on their appearance together. Here we can see Nicole Kidman applying deodorant, is that right? And Helena brushing her teeth. Another example is that one, where Alice is brushing her hair, and they actually, I don't think they ever really talk to each other, except in one scene. And it kind of, but also makes sense that Alice would do the best to kind of make her daughter look pretty, because she's called Helena. She's called Helena for a reason, kind of to quote Marlowe here, I think, because she's supposed to be the face that launched 1,000 ships. You are not that if you don't look pretty, so she has to work on that. So she's kind of like destined to be this beautiful child or woman. Yeah, and that is kind of another example of how they don't actually communicate, because here we see Helena watching TV and Alice reading news while they're both having breakfast, sort of. And there's no communication, so they only connect via this curation of their beauty, and they don't do anything apart from that, and they never really talk. Except for one scene, as I said, when they talk about the maths homework that Helena has to do, which, however, is completely about comparing boys' finances. So it's like, we got Tim and Max and whoever, and who has the most money. So I think this film, in this sense, would not pass the Bechdel test, obviously. And yeah, so I think it's just quite telling that the connection that they have is basically based on curating their beauty and talking about money and how to find the guy with the most money. Yeah, the final scene, the shopping scene, is, I think, quite foreshadowing for Helena's development. Because we always see her picking up these very traditional toys. So here she's picking up a Barbie, and then she has this buggy, which I think Alice calls old-fashioned. And before that, Helena's like, it's pretty. And she's like, it's old-fashioned. That's why it's pretty. So again, we see that Alice is quite aware of these very old school types, and she really likes them, and she likes to stick by them. And now, possibly very close reading, but I think just a very telling one, because in the background here we see these two older men holding the teddy bear, and on the right side the tiger again. It was also seen in Domino scene. And then we actually see Helena walking past them, walking over to the two older men, because they had the teddy bear that was already earlier seen in Helena's bedroom. And then she goes around the corner and we don't see her. So she's kind of going away with these older guys because they have the teddy bear that was already in the bedroom. So they're kind of contributing, I think, to this idea of her being a trophy wife, or possibly becoming one. So, possibly the shortest talk. quick summary, sorry. Summarize it. So Helena is becoming this trophy wife like her mother because she is conforming to these gender norms, and she's being taught how to look pretty and how to do them and everything, and she's really sticking to them. And because her mother is just a housewife or trophy wife, she doesn't know anything apart from that. So she's being taught that women can be housewives and trophy wives, but there's nothing beyond that, and that is what presumably it's going to make Helena a trophy winner. Thank you.